What's up, guys? A little bit of a late start to the day. I've just sat around and just been applying for loads of jobs and for Australia and so forth, all that sort of crap. Anyway, I'm going to head down into town, into Doomagey, and go down to like the boulevard and just have a little walk around and explore Doomagey. Just had a brief 5 minute walk down into the Doomagey Museum. So we just got in and we have to give our IDs in, and we get this little visitor pass. So yeah, just gonna have a walk around. We got to walk down here and then turn left and then into the museum. I have no idea what museum it is, but been told to come down here, so why not? Let's see what type of museum it is. Right, guys, so that's all finished up. We're still in there for about maybe half an hour. Definitely worth going down if you're in Doomagey. Sorry, it's a little bit loud, there's traffic everywhere. But 50 pesos to get in, and it's good to actually go into a museum of some sort just to get a bit of history for the Philippines, because I feel like I haven't done that as much. Anyway, I'm just in the, we're gonna walk up to the middle of the town. I'm gonna look for a charger for my MacBook, because the charger for my MacBook is broken. Literally just one thing after another. So gonna try and hunt for that and get some food. Scratch that. I'm gonna go down to the Doomagey Boulevard, which is just at the end of this road over here. Go, 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 go. Don't get run over. It's back to work. Clap rappers around to prove the game. What? You wanna battle me? Yo, man, how much money you got? What? Be thorough to the end. So, first time going into a 7-Eleven in the Philippines. Didn't even know they existed on this side of Asia. But I got myself a stuffed pandesal, which is that. Little microwave munch, and it's got bacon and chicken inside. So let's see what it tastes like. And yeah, that bun was well nice. Yeah, 30 pesos, well worth it. It was like 50p, little snack. Just walked through a whole little market. I'm assuming it opens up quite big at night. But yeah, walked through a long road and didn't get hassled once by anyone. Normally when you go into like a market in Asia, everyone's like, oh yeah, yeah, hello, do you want this, do you want that? 2-for-1, all this sort of stuff, which is really, really annoying. Obviously they see you as a Westerner, they see like money on your head, but yeah, no, it was quite nice, quite peaceful. Anyway, just got through to some opening here. I think we're in right in the middle of Doomagey, and this is what it looks like. Oh, I nearly slipped then. Slippery flow. I have no idea what's going on over there. No idea, but there's a giant Christmas tree over there. So strange how it's like 35 degrees and it's just so hot and it's Christmas. It's so strange. this is the Caminario de Dumaguete. It got built in the 1970s and it's just one of the things to have a look at when you're in Dumaguete. It was just one of the watchtowers that was built when all the Spanish was here. So yeah, pretty cool to see, pretty tall. Just got myself back into the plaza. I'm gonna go to the top floor, get myself a munch. But I was gonna say, it's just funny how whatever like supermarket or like a big store you go into, you have to go through like metal detector and get your like bag searched and that, which yeah, pretty sick. You never really get that back home, and it's quite secure. And some places, if you do have a big bag, then you'll have to check it in round the corner and then get a little receipt, and then you don't have to pay for it, but then you get your bag up back after, just so you don't take your bag in. But hey, each to their own. So on the food court, I got myself a chicken mami, which is a noodle chicken sort of soup, and it was 40 pesos. So that is just so cheap. Nice little snack, and yeah, under a pound, it's like 60-70p. There's a reason why that's 55 pesos.
What is it?
Chicken mami.
Chicken soup.
It's like a noodle soup, but it doesn't taste that good. I'm getting more food. Right, I was not satisfied by that food, so I got myself some pork asado, got some rice, and what else did I get? I got some sweet and sour meatballs, so yeah, I'm gonna dig into this, I'm so hungry. Right, what should I do, rice in there or there rice?
There rice.
These are the little plates that I have at home. These little plastic pieces. Very nice.
All right.
Should we
have a fork
dish, eh? Are we gonna make like Chinese bun bread?
Yeah.
So nice. Ah! Yeah, that was so much better. I feel satisfied and full. Yes. How you feeling, bro?
Gravy. So we're back up at Lee Plaza and we are eating again up here, dirt cheap. Cost me 37 pesos for some nachos.
Tell me, man, when you move?
Right, time to go to the Lee Plaza supermarket, which is just down there. Gonna get myself a couple of snacks and some bread and eggs and that, because we have a kitchen in the hostel, so I'm gonna cook some food again tonight and tomorrow morning. Traffic in Dumaguete. Right, shopping is done. I got myself some bread, eggs, mayo, lettuce, some crisps, and a bottle of water for like 200 pesos, which is it's like £3. So yeah, not bad. 12 eggs for like a pound. So sick. Just heading back into the hostel now. It's just getting dark. The traffic is everywhere. Traffic is mental. But yeah, I went to the phone shop. I had to get my phone back because when I got the screen fixed, the LCD was broke as you saw yesterday, so I got it fixed yesterday. However, he fixed that, but he broke the volume buttons, he broke the home button, and he broke something in the motherboard that stops the music coming out of the iPhone, which is really, really annoying. So he fixed one thing, but broke three things. So I've got to go back tomorrow. He's going to give me a call and find a motherboard or something to put it back in so he can fix everything with no extra charge, thank God. But nothing is never really easy in Southeast Asia, so yeah. Gonna be the third time going to him. Hopefully get it fixed tomorrow. Let's get back to the hostel. He's all right, isn't he? Oh, he's about to fall asleep. No, don't hit him. Oh, he's about to fall asleep.